Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah. Tonight's dua, subhanallah. Let me ask you before I tell you the dua. Who is the most beloved daughter to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa? Without any doubt, Fatima radiallahu anha wa ardaha. So this is how the hadith started. He said, ya Fatima, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa have so many methods of teaching. And one of them is to excite you before he teaches you. And so he is telling her, ya Fatima, ma yamna'uki, what prevents you from this wasiyya that I'm giving you? And we all know wasiyya in Arabic, it means an advice that is so essential. That's why they call, before you die, they call it wasiyya. You know, your will, your the most important thing you will tell the people before you leave. So, ya Fatima, I'm gonna, what prevents you from this wasiyya I'm about to give you? What is the wasiyya, ya Rasulullah? He said, say every morning and every evening. That means this is one of the adhkar of the sabah and the adhkar of the masa. Ya hayyu ya qayyum, bi rahmatika astaghith, aslih li sha'ni kullah, wa la takilni ila nafsi tarfat ayn. Most of us know the dua, but wallahi, today I'm going to explain it in a way you're going to adore the dua, you're going to love the dua so much. Ya Hayyu Ya Qayyum. Those two names of Allah Azza wa Jal, there is a hadith from Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that he said the greatest name of Allah, because Allah has a name that's called the greatest name. He said the greatest name of Allah is in three surahs, Baqarah, Al Imran, and Taha, right? And the only two names that are repeated in those three surahs are Ya Hayy Ya Qayyum, Al Hayy Al Qayyum. Al-Hayy Al-Qayyum. So I'm asking Allah Azza wa Jal with the best of his names. And this is what the opinion of Imam al-Nawawi, rahimahullah, that this is the best name of Allah. The majority of the ulama, they said that the best name of Allah is actually Allah. Ya Hayyu Ya Qayyum. I am Hayy. You are Hayy. But this Hayy is temporary. Why should I please this Hayy? Why should I ask this Hayy for something that he cannot handle, or it's limited how long he can handle it? Let me ask the Hayy alladhi la yamut. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, he said in the Quran, al Hayy alladhi la yamut in Surah Al Furqan. He is the Hayy that does not die. So I'm asking him by this name, Ya Hayy, Ya Allah, you are the all living. Ya Qayyum, Ya Hayyu Ya Qayyum. Qayyum is the one that is qa'im by himself. He does not need anyone to help him in anything. Self-sustainable. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not sleep, does not get tired, does not need to eat, does not need to drink. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qa'im. After everything has perished, Allah is still there. And he's the only one that will be there. Ya Hayyu Ya Qayyum. Two beautiful names of Allah Azza wa Jal. Ya Hayyu Ya Qayyum. In the dua, etiquettes, we learned praise, then ask, right? Always, like even the Fatiha. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, praise. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, praise. Maliki Yawm al-Din, praise. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in, praise. And then I ask, ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. Right? Always praise. So here I'm praising. Ya Hayyu Ya Qayyum. Bi rahmatika astaghith. I'm praising here too. Bi rahmatika. With your mercy, I listen to this verb. Astaghith. Astaghith is the verb from ghawth. Ghawth in Arabic, if you look at the translation of astaghith, seek help, need, you know, very simple words. But wallahi, it's far beyond that. Astaghith is, I am literally drowning, and I'm raising my hand, please help me. I'm gone, I'm dead. If you don't help me, I'm destroyed. This is ghawth. So when you say need, it's not really the right translation. Astaghith is I'm in dire need. Dire need for what? To your rahmah, ya Allah. Wallahi, akhwan, the only reason you came to Isha and you were able to pray Isha is because of the rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jal. You were able only to digest that food that you ate because of the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have those beautiful kids running at home because of the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We cannot survive a fraction of a second without his rahmah. And we all know that is the only key to Jannah, no matter what we do. Bi rahmatika astaghith. Tayyib. Now, I praised. Ask. What do you want? Aslih li sha'ni kulla. Ya Allah. Rectify, fix, repair, mend, whatever you want in the word aslih. Ya Allah, my affairs are a mess. I'm having problems at home, I'm probably having problems at work, problems with my health, problems with my in-laws, problems with my children, problems with my neighbor, problems in my salat, problems in my ibadat. I have many problems, Ya Allah. Aslih li sha'ni kulla. Fix all my affairs, Ya Allah. All my affairs, all of them. Me and my spouse, Ya Allah, please make our home a Jannah on earth. Ya Allah, fill our home with love and mercy. Ya Allah, make my relationship with my parents the best. Ya Allah, me and my children are getting along. Ya Allah, please fix that. Ya Allah, me and my boss are always fighting. I don't like my job. Ya Allah, please make me like it, make it better for me. Fix all my affairs, all my affairs. We've been saying this dua for such a long time, but the meaning of it is so deep and so beautiful. He's giving this wasiyah to his best and most beloved daughter. And of course, from her to all Muslims. Aslih li sha'ni kulla. What else do you want? Wa la takilni ila nafsi tarfat ayn. Ya Allah, I have no clue how to manage my affairs. I am helpless. I don't know how to put everything in order. Ya Allah, All my affairs are a mess. Ya Allah, I do not know how to make decisions on my own. Ya Allah, do not leave me to my own decision, not for a minute, not for an hour, not even for a blink of an eye. Tarfat ayn. Do not make me make my own decisions, Ya Allah, for a blink of an eye. For a blink of an eye, I cannot handle it. You are the mudabbir, you are the hakim, you are the all-wise, you are the all-expert, you are the all-knowing, you know the unseen. I do not know. I might make a decision, I want to marry this woman and she's not good for me and I really want her. And I really want to move this, move there and I open that business and they might be the worst thing could ever happen to me. But you, Ya Allah, you know what's going to happen in the future. عالم الغيب والشهادة. Ya Allah, do not make me make one decision by my own. I want you, Ya Allah, to please run all my affairs. Subhanallah. How beautiful is this dua, Ya Akhwan? Ya Hayyu Ya Qayyum. Bi rahmatika astaghith. Aslih li sha'ni kulla. Wa la takilni ila nafsi tarfat ayn. Yalla, ya shabab. Ya Hayyu Ya Qayyum. Bi rahmatika astaghith. Aslih li sha'ni kulla. Wa la takilni إلى نفسي طرفة عين. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us memorize this dua, apply this dua, and may He subhanahu answer this dua. We'll see you at 5 a.m. inshallah for the salat. And if you cannot make it, come to 6:15 for Fajr. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ والذين هم عن اللغو معرضون والذين هم للزكاة فاعلون والذين هم لفروجهم حافظون إلا على أزواجهم أو ما ملكت أيمانهم فإنهم غير ملومين.